to you.
She was a member of the Chiefs Club.
Yeah.
I don't think she is anymore. Going away to college, really, you lose a lot of people with that.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody ready?
Good evening, everyone. I'm going to call the meeting to order. Would everyone please stand for a short prayer and a salute to our flag? Almighty God, grant us the wisdom to make those decisions that are in the best interest of all our residents. May the Heavenly Father of us all bless those who have given the ultimate sacrifice in service to our nation, and may he watch over and protect our servicemen and women now guarding the gates of freedom. Do you have some grandchildren that could lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, Tom?
No.
They're not there yet.
They're on their way. Go ahead.
All right. Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Terry, statement of publication.
Yes, Mayor, take notice that this regular meeting of the Mayor and Borough Council being held on the 9th day of May 2016 has been advertised and posted in accordance with Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231, Public Law 1975.
Roll call.
Councilpersons Buchanan.
Here.
Rillo.
Here.
Kilpatrick.
Here.
Lembo.
Here.
Novak.
Here.
Rittenhouse.
Here.
Council President, approval of prior minutes.
Thank you, Mayor. I move the following be approved, subject to correction: the April 6, 2016 receipt of bids, April 20th, 2016 receipt of bids, and April 21st, 2016 receipt of bids.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, Mary?
Okay. Would the mayor and council meet me around the front? Mr. Palando and your family, would you like to come up? Right in front, all you babies, look at the camera so you can see yourself on TV. You rest of your family coming, Tom? Well, I'll talk slow. I have the distinct honor, the mayor has allowed me to present this to Tom. It came as a surprise to me when we had our opening day of Sayreville AA. Tom was giving up the presidency after 40 years, retire. I started to cry. He didn't even want any of us to know. He didn't want anything. And so I started to call people, and I wanted to do something for him at the council meeting. And I kept it a secret all the way till Friday, till Mr. Gorillo sent him a copy of the agenda and he saw that it was on there. But his family really did yeoman duty keeping it a secret in the AA and the rec department. So I'm going to read this now. Whereas Thomas Tom Palando was born in Brooklyn to Albert and Angelina Palando on September 25th, 1948, he later married Rosemarie Moriello in 1971, and they had three sons, Robert, David, and Nicholas, who gave them 10 beautiful grandchildren. I added beautiful. And whereas Tom has generously volunteered to the borough of Sayreville for over 44 years, he has served as president to the Athletic Association for 40 years, 10 years with the Morgan Athletic Association, and 30 years with the Sayreville Athletic Association. During Tom's tenure as president of Morgan AA, the Sayreville Athletic Association, over 20,000 Sayreville children have participated in many programs offered by this organization, including basketball, softball, street hockey, competitive cheerleading, basketball, buddy ball, buddy baseball, and many batters, my little guys, my three-year-olds. In conjunction with these sports programs, the Sayreville Athletic Association holds annual events such as Easter egg hunts, Halloween parade, toy drives, and breakfast with Santa. And whereas Tom has been a member of the borough's Recreation Advisory Board for 16 years, and whereas he has also served the community, being an elected councilman of the borough of Sayreville in 2002 and serving through 2006, he was also chosen and served as council president during the year 2003, 2004, 2006, and 2007. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the governing body of the borough of Sayreville do hereby recognize Tom Palando for his dedicated services to the borough of Sayreville, its residents, and its children, and it's signed by the council. Thank you, Tom, for all of your years. Tom, would you like to say a few words?
It's one of the best days of my life to be honored here. I'm a little upset my other children aren't here. They're probably on their way. I know they are. But I want to thank the Sayreville Athletic Association for putting this together with the council. My deep appreciation to the mayor and council. I know there's times that we may be on the other side of the aisle. The mayor and council, they're public servants, and the work that they do, the tireless work that they do every day for next to nothing, no money at all, can't even pay for their cleaners. They're some of the greatest volunteers that this borough has. And talking about the volunteers, we are so rich here in Sayreville with volunteerism. From the time that I started and I met probably the greatest volunteer of all, Mickey Sedlak, and I learned a lot from Mickey, and after Mickey, Jerry Carney, and after Jerry Carney, my friend and one of the founders, Jerry Ust. But if I look around at all the other organizations, the Little League, Bob Vermeil, Mike Burns, and now, you know, Joanna DeMille, Pat Walsh, you know, Eric Hausman, so many in all the organizations that we have, they're great organizations. And I hope that we're able to continue our great volunteerism, such as first aid, fire. We are so, so rich with volunteerism. But things have changed here in Sayreville, as well as around the state, around the country. And organizations are hurting. Things are changing. Traveling organizations. None more than our football organization. Here in Sayreville, we always had great football organizations. And now we're on the verge of two football organizations, the Panthers and the Leprechauns. If we don't do something, mayor and council, we'll end up losing this. And we need to find a way to get these two organizations together and come up with one so we could have one great organization, which is why we have the Sayreville AA back 30 years ago, there was, you know, Laurel Park, Sayreville Girls, and Morgan AA. We found a way of merging these three organizations, Will Velez from Laurel Park, Debbie Cook from Sayreville Girls, and myself. It wasn't about the name, we changed the name. It's about the children. So I asked the mayor and council to get together to talk to both the Panthers and the Leprechauns. Find a way. We need better helmets. We need to make our children safe. God bless Sayreville. God bless the United States. And God bless all of you. And thank you so much. for making this happen. Thank you.
Tom, congratulations. Thank you for everything you've done with the children in town. Okay, and best luck. And I'm sure you'll still be around with a lot of other things.
Tom, I've had the pleasure of working with you in many different ways, but here's the fam. Here's the rest. Come on up, guys. It's quite a train.
Beautiful babies,
right? Well, wait, get them all in. We're good. You know, as a chairman, all the different hats that you wear, but I started playing for the Sayreville AA when it was Morgan. I was 8, and honestly, you've always been a fixture at that field. So I think one of the biggest roles that you play, and one that I hope to continue and help you with, is being on that field, coaching those kids, and it's an honor to have my own daughters playing now and sitting with you in your special chair to talk about everything softball and beyond. Thank you for everything that you've done for these organizations.
Tom, congratulations. I'd just like to thank you for the countless hours over the years. I can imagine in all those years, countless time and effort you put into the children of Sayreville. Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Tom, thank you, and to your family, thank you for giving Tom for many years. I did ended my baseball career in Sayreville AA. I was a Sayreville Little League guy up until my last year. I also coached in college through Tom's organization, and it was a great organization, and it gave a lot of opportunity to the kids of Sayreville. So, Tom, thank you for your years.
I didn't grow up in Sayreville, but my wife did. And I know that when I moved here, she says, you're not going to believe how important youth sports are in Sayreville. And I just said, oh, come on, how big of a deal could it be? It's just Little League, it's just football. And then as I've gotten to know Tom, and I've gotten to know so many wonderful folks in this community, it is, as Tom said, it's about the volunteering and taking the time to build the fabric of a community, and it's based on this youth sports. And I thank all the volunteers, and I thank Tom for all the great work, because it really makes Sayreville a better place to live.
Thank you. Rosemary, I would be remiss if I didn't thank you for the permission you gave for all these decades for your husband to not be in the home but to be on the playing fields of Sayreville. You're an unsung heroine, but you're being recognized tonight. Tom, as you said, we agree to disagree on many issues, but not this one. A great job. It will be a difficult set of shoes to fill, if ever. And the people of Sayreville are grateful, and you made a difference. Thank you.
At this time, I like to bring up the person that's going to carry the torch on and going to build this. And she's fabulous. I mean, as I said on opening day, I knew it was time for me to move on when she was putting baseball curtains in the trailer. So she's come up with some new ideas, and this year was the what's the name of it? The bunnies, the mini batters, and we have almost 100 of them, and it's fabulous just to see these little children run around having a good time. And you know, as I said, you know, things have changed, and what the AA is trying to do is give children a place to play for as cheap as possible. You know, a great program, but for $20. I mean, it's a fabulous program. Thank you, Sue, Jimmy, Kenny, Judy, Kieran, and all the rest of the volunteers. My buddy there, Joe Ambrosio, when I talk about the founders, Diane Ambrosio was one of the founders of the Sayreville AA. She was there for me, and Kenny's mom and the Huguenin family. So God bless you all. I thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. And once again, Sue, say.
Mayor, you said it right. I will never fill those shoes. 43 years, I've only seen a piece of it. For those of you who have ever experienced a day with the Sayreville Athletic Association, baseball, softball, it's just a piece of it. This man, regardless of what you think of him in the political arena or not, has done more for the children of this community that I've ever seen than anyone else. I have four of them in it, so I can speak as a mom. The sports, the activities. I pledge today to continue to build what you began, and I will never forget where it came from.
God bless all of you. I know you guys have a lot of business to go through. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
I did that without crying.
I know, I too.
You didn't.
Bill is in here because Haley's on the field right now.
Terry, next item.
Yes, Mayor, to new business, I'd like to report having received the supplemental debt statement from Wayne A. Kronowski, our CFO, as of May 9th, 2016. Need a motion to receive and file?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
It was Councilman Limbo or Grillo? My mic was. I'm sorry, I have to get used to the voices yet. I can't look up in time. Okay, we have the introduction of the following ordinances. Ordinance number 32916, bond ordinance providing for the replacement of water main in Quade Street from Washington Road to its terminus in the borough of Sayreville, New Jersey, appropriating $400,000 therefore and authorizing the issuance of $400,000 bonds or notes of the borough for financing part of such appropriation.
Councilwoman Novak.
I move the ordinance be approved on first reading, advertised according to law, a public hearing to be held on May 23rd, prevailing time.
Second.
All in favor? We have need a roll call.
Roll call, please.
Roll call.
Councilperson Novak?
Yes.
Buchanan?
Yes.
Grillo?
Yes.
Kilpatrick?
Yes.
Limbo?
Yes.
And Rittenhouse?
Yes.
Thank you. Introduction of Ordinance Number 330-16, bond ordinance providing for supplemental appropriation of $200,000 for the renovation of the former Bordentown Avenue Water Treatment Plant in the borough of Sayreville, County of Middlesex, New Jersey, and authorizing the issuance of $200,000 bonds or notes of the borough for financing part of such appropriation.
Councilwoman Novak?
I move the ordinance be approved in first reading, advertised according to law for public hearing to be held on May 23rd, prevailing time.
Second.
Roll call.
Councilperson Novak?
Yes.
Buchanan?
Yes.
Grillo?
Yes.
Kilpatrick?
Yes.
Limbo?
Yes.
Rittenhouse?
Yes.
Introduction of Ordinance Number 331-16, Ordinance amending and supplementing Chapter 4 of the Revised General Ordinances of the Borough of Sayreville to amend Section 4-19, Employment of Off-Duty Police Officers.
Councilman Limbo?
Yes, Mayor. The committee, along with Dan Frankel, met with the Chief of Police and representatives from the PBA, and I believe...
Pat, is your mic on?
Yeah. Oh. I believe we finally have all the details worked out, all the legal wording. I do have one question, Dan. I believe the original request was for 65, July 1, then going to 75.
That's correct. That adjustment has to be made in this amendment. So can we,
it's all
can
in
we
agree- make- if it's all in agreement, then I can just go ahead and make the change before we advertise.
Right. So you can go ahead and introduce it with the understanding that it will be modified.
Is everyone in agreement with that?
Yes.
Okay. Go ahead and introduce it then, Councilman.
Okay. I move the ordinance be approved on first reading, advertised according to law, public hearing be held on May 23rd.
Second.
Roll call.
Councilpersons Lembo.
Yes.
Buchanan.
Yes.
Grillo.
Yes.
Kilpatrick.
Yes.
Novak.
I'm recusing myself.
And Rittenhouse.
Yes.
Thank you. That's all I have at this time. Mayor, we need to go into closed session.
We need to go into closed session. How long, Councilor?
Only 10 minutes.
Okay.
You now, therefore, be it resolved.
Is that an ominous 10 minutes?
Yes, I think Mr. Merriman says it's going to be quick.
Okay.
Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Mayor and Borough Council. The public portion of this meeting is hereby adjourned in the order that the governing body may meet in closed private session for approximately 10 minutes to discuss personnel and litigation. Following the conclusion of said closed session, the governing body shall reconvene the open portion of this meeting to consider the interim matters. Minutes will be kept, and once a matter involving the confidentiality of the above no longer requires that confidentiality, then the minutes can be made public.
Move the resolution be approved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Chief, if you'd come with Mr. Merriman, please.
What is this about?
Location pay.
I have trouble with that.
Question.
To us. Please provide security in the library.
Take a motion to go back into open?
So moved. Excuse me.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? With that, we will go to the public portion on the consent agenda. Anyone having any questions or comments on consent agenda items, please come forward. Just so there's a little bit of a change tonight in the council chambers. I received a note from a resident, a Mr., how do you pronounce this, Terry? Bilkowski on Mini Sink, and he said you can't see who's speaking when they're at the podium, so I asked Terry to move it back to the center. So with that, are there any questions or comments on the consent agenda? Being no questions or comments, I'll entertain a motion. Council President.
I move the public portion be closed and the consent agenda resolution items be approved on roll call vote.
Second.
Roll call.
Councilperson Buchanan?
Yes.
Grillo?
Yes.
Kilpatrick?
Yes.
Lembo?
Yes, with the exception of 2016-132.
That would be a nay?
Be a no on that.
Thank you. Councilwoman Novak?
Yes.
Rittenhouse?
Yes, with the exception of 2016-132. That'll be a no.
Is there any discussion on this or no? I mean, I just wanted to know if there's any reason why Mr. Rittenhouse and Mr. Lembo voted no on
this late date on the budget?
Well, this is really the first opportunity we've had to discuss it. At the last meeting, we received the final budget right before the meeting started. So my only issue was, in light of all the money we're going to have to be spending on the radios, we're still spending like $1.5 million on new vehicles. I think if it's not absolutely an emergency, I think we should reconsider some of those new vehicles.
Well, then, let's not adopt the budget tonight, and we'll discuss that.
Yeah, but the vote's been taken.
Okay. I just, if there was any problem, we had many, many meetings. This budget has not changed since the last meeting that we had. We had an introduction of the budget. 3 weeks later, we had second reading on it. Tonight, this is months. You've had the opportunity to come forward to Wayne, Dan, myself. At no time did you make any indication that you were not happy with this. But then again.
Mayor, you just understand that it's just something political at this point. I mean, both of them voted no on it without any comment beforehand or discussion beforehand. They just wanted to vote no blanketly.
I think that's really a disservice to do for the town.
This is the opportunity for discussion.
No, you had plenty of time.
There was no opportunity for discussion. We were given the budget the day of the meeting.
You had a public hearing.
We had a public hearing. You had the opportunity to speak.
And then it went back to your committee.
Am I missing something?
No, it did.
The budget did pass.
Yes, it did, Mayor. And I want to know why, that this, at this late date, that both Republicans are not going along with a budget that they've had more than an opportunity. I mean, we kind of sat there and went over the capital budget line by line by line by line. And at that time, nobody had any problems with it. We've had agenda meetings. That's where this discussion between the mayor and council is supposed to happen. That is where it's supposed to happen, and there was nothing said. You both sat very quiet, so I guess it wasn't a problem then, or I don't know. Obviously, the residents of this town are the ones that are not being worried about, this is the people you don't care about. Thank you.
Okay, at this time I'm going to open the public portion for questions or comments on any and all issues. Are there any questions or comments? Seeing no questions or comments, I'll entertain a motion to close the public portion.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, I'm going to open up the agenda portion.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
A motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? I'm going to call the meeting to order. Salute to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Terry's statement of publication.
Mayor, take notice that this agenda meeting of the Mayor and Borough Council being held on this 9th day of May 2016 has been advertised and posted in accordance with Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231, Public Law 1975.
Roll call.
Councilpersons Buchanan.
Here.
Grillo.
Here.
Kilpatrick.
Here.
Lembo.
Yep.
Novak.
Here.
Rittenhouse.
Here.
Okay, call out if you have any questions or comments on the following ordinances: 329-16, 330-16, 331-16. I do have an appointment tonight. I have several appointments, actually. They're all to the Human Relations Committee. Mm-hmm. And that would be Joe Malara, his brother Tony Malara.
There's only two, Mayor.
No, I have one right here.
There's two openings. There's only two availabilities.
Oh, there's only two. Well, there are three. There are
that
three.
Courtney?
Courtney resigned. Yeah, that's including Courtney.
Courtney resigned.
Mm-hmm. That includes his vacancy.
Okay, and then I have a third from Harshad Patel. Let's do it in order. Joseph Malara, is there a motion?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? So I'm just reading these in the manner in which I received them. I mean, 2-8, 2-8, 5-2, and the date also. Okay, Tony Malara, is there a motion?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, so Mr. Patel will be carried over to the next time there's an opening. Okay, with that, we'll go to communications and committee reports. Administration and Finance, Councilwoman Novak.
Yes, Mayor. Okay, I moved that the following minutes that are listed on the agenda, Board of Education Council combined meetings, April 19th.
Second.
You receive and file? Okay. There were several applications for bingo or raffle licenses at Cerebral Engine Company, Animal Rescue Force, and RJC Charities as listed on the agenda.
Any objections? Next item.
Okay, an application for a social affair received from PBA Local 98 to serve beer at their annual picnic being held
Any
at
objection?
Burks Park.
Anything else, Councilwoman?
Yes, I'd like to say this weekend down at Kennedy Park, there's a lot of fun things going on. The Human Relations Commission is having a fun run. We're also having the, well, I'm sure Danny's going to talk about it, but the Fishing Derby will also be going on there. So if you go to one, please stop by and talk to the people at the other one. This is an annual event, and it very well attended. Also, I've been in communication with a Mr. Rudko. He lives, though, for people that don't know, he was one of the people that were affected, not so much by the flood from Superstorm Sandy, but in the aftermaths of the new flood zone. There's just a small section of houses over in Eisenhower that are being told that they will now be in a flood zone. Their flood insurance will go up well over $3,000, which is unaffordable for most people. They also, because they never flooded before, they're not available for a buyout. It's kind of a catch-22. It's kind of a catch-22. Now, can you still hear me? Okay. They're effectively, what's happening is the federal government is taking their property without any recourse because they won't be able to sell this property and they can't afford to keep it. And I don't know how the time frame goes for maybe getting more input on the scientific data so that we can ask the government once again if they will please reconsider putting this in a floodplain. The window of opportunity for fixing that may have closed, but I'd like the council to back me up on this and asking, Mr. Frankel to find out if there's still any window of opportunity to refute the floodplain. Maybe there's more scientific data out there that we can get that'll help us with this.
Jay, do you have any comments on this? I know you've done extensive work on this area.
Well, Mayor, we wrote a report to the state. We could not find any problems with the scientific data, but we did think that it made sense because the Army Corps is still studying the need for a flood improvement project. If that flood improvement project was constructed, there wouldn't be a need to go through and raise the elevation in that area and in turn charge the higher flood insurance rate. So we recommended that action be deferred until the Army Corps project is completed, or at least the studies completed. The state did not go through and agree with that. So at this point, I don't know if there's anything with scientific data, but we may want to pursue further the Army Corps and see if we can get it deferred because they are still looking at flood improvements.
Okay, maybe Mr. Frankel can talk to some of the contacts he made at the DEP.
Yeah. Mayor.
And see if there's a third way. Arthur?
Yes, I've been dealing with Mr. Rutko too for the last 3 years, and some of the things there, Mary, you said houses can't be sold. Unfortunately, realtors have sold houses, one right across the street from them. And they're not telling the people because the flood maps officially haven't been, they're not telling the people that it's a flood zone. The other thing is Mr. Rutko has gone to many meetings, and one of them is with Congressman MacArthur from the 3rd Congressional District. He's trying to get FEMA to do some things. Also, Berkeley Township passed a resolution, and maybe this is something that Mr. DuPont or Mr. Frankel can get, grandfathering in those people in their town that have had that problem so that they can solve this. And again, this brings back to what I was saying, that people who are trying to switch insurance in Sayreville, both of our zip codes are considered a flood zone and nobody's issuing new policies. So if you have homeowners and think you can get a better buy with somebody else, they're not going to take you because they're using our zip code. And that's something we, as a council, Mary, we also.
You know what? If I might interject, if in case that's accurate regarding to the realtors, we may want to make an inquiry into the Board of Realtors down in the state.
It seems to me that's illegal.
To make a claim on behalf of those. I'll check into that if the mayor and council wish that to occur.
Please.
Anything else, Mayor?
What Art had mentioned, I had a copy of that. I never thought I'd say this, but right now the people on Weber Avenue were the lucky ones because they got buyouts. And these other people are in this situation where because they never flooded before, they're not available for buyouts. But because their house and these few, I mean, it's just a handful of houses in the middle of the development over here that are just a little bit too low. And as Art said, some of the realtors are deceptively selling houses without reporting that. You don't have to report it, but if somebody asks a question, you have to, and maybe people don't know. But once the floodplains are official, that will have to be recorded on the deed, and that will make the houses unsellable. Nobody's going to buy a house that's sitting in a flood zone, and that kind of increase in their insurance is just more than people can bear. So we're, I mean, so many times in town, we say we have all of this property and we want to rezone it and so that you can't build as many units on it. And we get sued by the property owners. And so many times we lose these lawsuits because the government will say you're effectively reducing the value of their property. Well, the government themselves right now are effectively taking these people's houses from them. And these are our people, our residents. They don't want to leave town. They'd love to be able to stay in their homes. But, you know, right now, they are the really big losers. And whatever we can do, whether it's to beg FEMA again to defer this, to wait till the Army Corps of Engineers, I mean, because that's just another branch of the federal government that really is slow walking this thing. I mean, at least the late 80s, they were talking about doing this. And, or maybe grandfathering some of these people in. Whatever we can do, I'd really like to, if the council is all behind me, let, you know, Dan and Mike work on this to do whatever we can to help these people out. Does anybody have a problem with that?
No.
Anything else, Mary?
Mayor, just let me check. I think that's it, Mayor.
Thank you. Planning and Zoning, Councilman Grillo.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Good evening, everyone. I move that the following minutes or reports be received and filed. The Board of Adjustment minutes of March 23rd, 2016, and the Middlesex County Planning Board minutes of April 12th, 2016.
Second.
Next item.
I ask that the council consider a request from the Township of Pawtuchen, which is requesting municipalities to support them in their resolution opposing the Pilgrim Pipeline, as it will adversely impact numerous significant natural areas and resources. Just for everyone's information, this was provided to me in this report, and they're concerned about an oil pipeline traveling from the Bakken Range in North Dakota, which would have natural gas and oil from fracking. So they're concerned about a number of issues, and their council voted unanimously to not support this and to ask that this project not occur in their municipality, and they've asked us to endorse that as well.
You understand there's no chance that it will ever go through the borough of Pawtuchen. No chance. Less than zero.
Well, then we should support it.
Less than zero. So I think we should, if you're going to object to this, I think you should really talk to the families whose income and livelihood is dependent on this pipeline, amongst many other facets to look at. But it coming through our municipality or the borough of Pawtuchen or a great many places in central Jersey is close to zero.
so.
Understood. So they've asked us, they voted 6-0 to not support this going through their town, and I think we should
You will find, as you sit up here, Councilman, these come with some frequency, these feel-good things.
So do we take action on it?
Why don't we put it under consideration?
Under consideration. All right.
It's being considered for the round file.
Fair enough. That's what they do to the freshman councilman.
Anything else, Councilman?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. First off, happy belated Mother's Day to everyone. Two quick items. Unfortunately, I think one of them is certainly very severe. As many of you know, two children were struck by a car by OLV about a week ago. And one was very, very seriously injured. And, you know, we talk about it all the time, but regardless of the situation, this particular incident, we've got a lot of folks who walk to bus stops and cross the street, people that jog, people that walk their dogs on Main Street, Washington Road, other streets. Don't text and drive. Follow the speed limit. Look twice before you turn. It's just a good time to remind everybody, remind yourselves. Two children were injured very severely because, and it could be anybody, it could be any of us, so just be very careful. Think of it as a civic duty. One other item. I want to thank Donna Zaleski and the Green Team. Last week we had an amendment or an introduction of some rules regarding dog tethering. And some of you guys might know that I'm a big animal advocate, and I think it's very important as the weather hopefully turns for the better, that if you do tether your animal outside, make sure they have water, they have shade, tether them with a harness, not a collar around their neck. A lot of people own pets and dogs in this town, so please be careful, give them the respect that they deserve, and be careful in how you treat them. So that came up through the Green Team, and I appreciate the work they did to bring that to the council's attention.
Anything else, Councilman?
That's all, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Public Safety, Councilman Limbo.
Thank you, Mayor. Request to receive and file a letter of resignation received from Antonio DiArpa as a regular member of Melrose Host Company Number 1.
Is there a second? Next item.
Need approval to request to travel received from Melrose Host Company Number 1 to attend the 100th anniversary at the Morganville Independent Fire Company on May 14th, 2016.
Any objections? Next item.
Request for a touring course at the intersection of Washington and Ernston Road from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. received from Sayreville Bombers Golf Program on June 11th, 2016.
Any objections? Anything else, Councilman?
That's it, Mayor, other than that, progress.
Thank you. Public Works, Councilwoman Kilpatrick.
Thank you, Mayor. There are no minutes or departmental reports this time, but I do have several requests. A request was received from the Sayreville PBA to use the borough's portable stage, and a request for the borough to reduce the park fee to the negotiated rate of $450, as they will be using their own personnel for cleanup.
Any objection? Next item.
A letter of resignation received from Jennifer Mennett from the Shade Tree Commission.
Thank you, Jennifer, for your tireless work. Next item.
And a request received from the Shade Tree Commission for the removal of Rich Herbin as a member of the commission due to a lack of participation.
Anybody, I mean, Rich has been on that for, God, a very long time, decades.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody reach out to Rich?
No, but I can do that if you wish. Yeah, I will. And
I mean, just out of respect.
I'm pretty sure that they
probably
did.
Probably 2 decades Rich has been active.
I'm pretty sure that they did, but I'll double check again.
Yep. Okay.
And just in addition, I believe Shade Tree also is going to be present at the Fishing Derby as well, giving out seedlings, as they've done in the past, I believe.
Okay.
And that's all, Mayor.
Thank
progress.
You. Water and Sewer, Councilman Rittenhouse.
Thank you, Mayor. Minutes and department reports. Move the following minutes of reports be received and filed. The Main Street Bypass Committee.
Is there a second?
Minutes of March 31st.
Second.
I have a question. What progress came out of that meeting, Councilman Rittenhouse? Any status on the project?
The meeting was just to review the fact that Jay will be attending our next meeting. This was one of the few Thursdays that he was not available. He had a previous. So Jay will be attending the May meeting.
And we had talked, I think it was not on the dais, but about opening Bamehurst Avenue because of the concerns over redundancy going down Wickshire Boulevard and Sheffield Mews, and that they do connect, but it would need to be opened at the end of Bamehurst, and then I believe paving project would need to be done. Did that come up at the meeting?
No, that's something for the council.
Yeah,
it was discussed.
I think the police had some opinion on that. Am I correct, Chief?
Yes.
They didn't want it open.
We asked that access be limited only for emergency.
At this time.
And at this time, there's...
This is a mayoral advisory committee with no power. It's made up of local area residents of the bypass road, the proposed bypass road, who have been fairly tireless in their examination and their recommendation. All decisions will come up here to the governing body.
Understood, and then I appreciate the work they're doing, but I don't, this was something that came up a number of months ago. I think I was sitting out there. I wasn't even elected yet when this came up, and nothing's happened. I'm just asking about the status of Bamehurst. Right now, can an emergency vehicle get down Bamehurst?
No.
Jay?
No.
No, so the problem hasn't been solved. So I'm just asking why the bypass committee hasn't either brought it to the police or the council. Let's just do it. It's a concern. Councilman Rittenhouse and I talked about it. We both live in that area. We would be adversely affected if there was an emergency on Wickshire. Just think it should be, I think that's the responsible group.
The council did give that direction to the police department, and public works should have been, you know, that was direction given by the council almost a year ago to do that, to set it, because there's guardrails that block that, plus there's a mound of dirt. So that's something that either Public Works or, and I know the police department had recommended the emergency access, so it would be Public Works, I guess, would be the ones who have to do the job.
Chief, would your people please review it and forward a recommendation, how it should be done? All right, thank you, Chief.
Mayor, Art, you said that Jay is gonna go to the Main Street Committee. Do you wanna, just for a formality, ask the council if it's all right for that?
We did last week, last meeting,
okay.
And you approved it.
Thank you, I'm sorry.
You're welcome.
Anything else, Councilman?
No, progress. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you. Recreation, Council President Buchanan.
Thank you, Mayor. I move the following minutes be received and filed, the Recreation Advisory Board minutes of April 7, 2016.
Second.
Thank you. Letter B, application for a special permit for RJC Charities. I'd like to have that approved.
Any objections? Anything else, Councilman?
Yes, Council just President. A couple quick things. The Fishing Derby is this Saturday, May 14th. From 8:30 to 9 is registration, 9 to 10:30 is the actual fishing derby, rain or shine. The townwide garage sale is still accepting registrations for June 4th at 8 a.m. is the townwide garage sale, $15 per house. Yankee tickets are still available for the Minnesota game and the Baltimore game. Movies in the park this year, June 18th is Star Wars.
God.
July 16th is Jurassic World. August 28th is Zootopia. And lastly, I would like to congratulate Aaron McQuaid, Saraville High School county champion in golf. It was the first time a female from Saraville won the county tournament. Other than that,
it's wonderful.
Progress.
Thank you, Council President. Again, a very happy Mother's Day to everyone in Saraville and across the nation. We all wouldn't be here unless we had a mother. And with that, I will go to the business administrator's report, Dan Frankel.
Thank you, Mayor. It's not listed in your program, but under your agenda session, but under administration and finance, we have had a situation where we appointed James Nolan as the special legal counsel to the Rent Living Board, and we had a number not to exceed $3,000. We have gone over $3,000. So I'd like to make a recommendation, considering he's also our tax attorney, that he gets paid on an hourly basis to continue that work, which the council asked him to continue, at, I believe, it's $150 per hour. If you want to put a limitation on it, that's up to you.
Okay. Is there any objection? Council recommends this.
Mr. Nolan's doing a very good job. This is
Mr.
Nolan's doing a very good job. He's been very, very attentive to this. The plaintiff has been fastidious and very detail-oriented, so it has been somewhat time-consuming.
Would you recommend he remain for the balance of the year?
Oh, yes, without question. Mr. Nolan's doing a wonderful job.
Yes. Okay.
So this would be a double thing, that he would remain as counsel to the Rent Leveling Board, attending their meetings, giving them legal guidance on these matters.
Yes.
Is there any objection? Wayne, do you have a number for it not to exceed for the balance of the year?
It's, you know, it would come out of a legal budget. There's, it's up to the council to decide that.
Well, what, what?
I don't know.
Not to exceed $10,000. There's another 7 months.
I don't know what's.
Let's split the difference. $7,500 not to exceed. If so, it has to come back to the council. Is everyone in agreement?
Could it be at an, I mean, an hourly rate? He does not attend every meeting unless he's asked to attend.
I understand, but we'll put, since we don't have a cap, most of the boards and commission have some kind of cap, particularly the smaller ones. So if it exceeds, in addition to what he's done, because this was a special
this
case.
This was a special situation. The Rent Leveling Board, I know, is extremely pleased with the work that he's done. But at the same time, I want to make sure that we do our due diligence here and making sure that.
Are you in agreement then? Mm-hmm. If he exceeds 7,500 any time.
That it comes back to the council.
In addition to what he's billed already.
In addition to.
Okay.
So the 3,000 that he currently has already, well, it is over that. So, but what, now originally the recommendation was 150 hourly rate?
No, the original recommendation not to exceed $3,000.
No, I meant outside
but his
of
rate for his rate that he charges us for other matters in the borough is $150 per hour.
How far has he exceeded the $3,000?
I believe right now it's close to about another $1,000 over the three, so it's about $4,000.
That was more than.
$4,000. He's up to $4,000. $10,000, Vicky. Not to exceed $10,000 for the year.
Including the four.
And that's including the four, right? I think that would be fair.
More than enough.
All right. Any objection? Do we need a motion for that to put on the next consent agenda?
I'll prepare the resolution and I'll speak to the clerk tomorrow regarding the language.
Okay. Next item.
Mayor, also under public safety, it was not brought up this evening, but I did speak to the chief and we were speaking to the consultant. I believe there should be a meeting. Dedicated meeting just for radios. The date that the consultant has available is May 31st, which is the Tuesday after Memorial Day. Wanted to take a straw poll and see if everyone is available that day.
Chief, does that work? Go ahead, Dan.
The problem, Chief, is that he's receiving one more situation back from Motorola that he thinks is not coming back until probably Thursday or Friday.
Okay, I can't attend that night, but it'll go forward. This is a priority.
The clerk can't make it that night, so we have to look at it. I know the problem.
All right. Okay. You know what? Talk to the clerk. See if we can do it next Monday. All right.
The consultant feels he probably won't be ready, Mayor.
Push him.
We have to advertise.
He can say yes, no, or maybe.
We have to advertise by Wednesday, end of business day on Wednesday. He's not going to have a bid received back from one of the vendors probably till Thursday, at the earliest. It's just you can push him, but he doesn't have the bid. You can't push him.
Okay. Well. How about the 18th, the 19th?
I asked the consultant all of the following next week. He's unavailable all of those evenings.
Okay. Chief, you need to talk to the consultant.
Oh, police memorial. Thursday night wouldn't be good because that's the police memorial.
When the chief is going to talk to the consultant, Dan will talk to the consultant. Let's see if we can get it moved up so we can put a priority on this.
Oh, God. No, I don't. That's a council meeting night. I'd rather have this separate. There's a lot.
Mayor, why don't we tentatively set it for the 16th? We can always withdraw it. We withdrew it from the last time.
Because
it was
of the
special meeting.
Of the advertising.
Okay.
So let's see how this works out, Chief, if you would. Dan, next item.
Authorization to reject all bids received for chain link fence and authorizing to re-advertise with amended specifications.
Any objection? Next item.
Authorization to appoint Rita Januzzi to the title of Clerk 3 in the Department of Public Works.
Any objection? Next item.
Authorization to amend AFSCME salary guide ordinance to include the title of field representative senior citizens and authorization to appoint Jeannie Monti to that title.
Any objection? Next item.
That's it, Mayor.
Okay, CFO's report, Wayne Kronowski.
Okay, the first item I had on there was in anticipation of the meeting on the 16th, but since it's not going to take, doesn't take place on the 16th, we can disregard that for now.
Okay.
I'll include it on my next agenda. B is, if the council so chooses, since the budget is adopted, we can have an ordinance for the acquisition of vehicles and equipment. So I had included a listing.
Next item.
Likewise, for park improvements, I can have a bond ordinance prepared for the next meeting for introduction.
Next item.
As per the capital improvement budget. You need a resolution rescinding the dedication by rider for the Storm Sandy donation. Okay. That was one of the provisions of the review of our budget, that they want to see that off our books. Even though there's no activity, the money was paid over to the charitable organization, but they want to see it off our books, so nobody can pick it up and use it. Okay.
Next item.
And the other one is a resolution authorizing a dedication by rider for affordable housing trust funds in case we receive any more.
Any objection? Anything else, Wayne?
That's it. No.
Borough Engineers Report, Jay Cornell.
Thank you, Mayor. First item is the improvements to Quake Street. We received bids for that project. You have an ordinance scheduled for second reading that'll appropriate additional funds. So if that goes through, we'd like to recommend a resolution at your next meeting awarding that contract.
Next item.
Second item, 2014 Road Project Phase 1. That's been completed. We're recommending closeout and a change order, which actually is going to be a $40,000 reduction. So we'd like a resolution for that.
Good work, Jay. Next item.
Next two items, Camden Street Water and repairs to Kennedy Park Skate Park. Tomorrow, we're receiving bids for both of those projects. So if everything's in order, we'd like to award contracts at your next meeting.
Thank you. Anything else, Jay?
That's it, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you. Borough Attorney's Report.
No report, Mayor.
Thank you. Anything for your closed session? At this time, we're going to open the public portion for questions or comments about any and all issues. Are there questions or comments? Yes, please come up. Please come up right to the podium and just state your name and the street that you live on.
My name is Harvey Schweiger. This is my wife, Mary Kate. I have a business at 4500 Bordentown Avenue.
Wait a minute.
Could you spell
Terry
your
didn't
name?
Get the full. Last name, could you spell your last name?
Sure. S-C-H-W-E-I-G-E-R.
And the name of your business?
Journey Mill Laundromat.
Okay. How can we help you?
I have a back payment of sewer and water bills.
Okay.
And the town is asking too much. I'm not disputing the amount.
Okay.
The town is asking too much in a monthly or quarterly payment. There's no way I could pay that amount. I will definitely pay everything.
Okay.
But I cannot pay the whole thing. I can't pay the amount that's being requested.
Can you wait till the meeting's over? The borough attorney will meet with you and we'll try to get it worked out.
Okay.
With you. Okay. You know, you could call my office. You don't have to come and wait through all this.
My landlord told me to come to the meeting, so I can't.
Okay.
Mayor, if I...
Okay, let me give you my number.
Mayor.
732.
I'll put it down for you. Thank you.
She knows it. But just give me a call. All right? I'm going to refer you to somebody, but you give me a call.
Okay.
Okay. 841-2022. You know, wow.
A little backwards.
15 years later.
That's right. I don't even know my husband's speed dial. When I had,
Standing behind you, Terry.
I didn't know how to call my husband.
We need to get yours, but stay so that the attorney, Michael Dupont, can speak to you.
Okay.
And Dan, you're going to talk to him? And the business administrator. Okay? We'll try to the best of our ability to work with you. Thank you for choosing Sayreville to open your business in. And we're going to be overjoyed when we get the water bill paid. Thanks. Are there any other questions or comments? Being no other questions or comments, I'll entertain a motion to close the public portion.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Take a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you, everyone. Have a very enjoyable evening.
Yeah, he said he didn't object to the bill.
Right. Take care, Mike.
Line formats are, when I was...
Take care. Take care, Steve.
How's it going, Wayne? Enjoy.